Balloon Stories from the Weekend. Let's do it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Hopefully you are enjoying your week. When this video is uploaded, I'm about to go into the weekend and getting ready for some more events, which means more stories can keep coming, and hopefully you guys share with me down below in the comments when you read these and relate to them and be like, man, dude, that happened to me too, or something similar. In the first one, I read an interesting comment actually, because I also do some face painting as well, and I had mentioned that this one kiddo was dressed up like a superhero, you know, to the nines or whatever, and when it came time to do the face paint, he wanted some completely different character. And that happens sometimes where you think like, oh, this is going to be a slam dunk. I'm going to be able to just paint this guy to go along with this costume, and it doesn't work out. But anyway, someone had mentioned below in that first video that there was a guy that wanted to be painted like a Dalmatian. And I can only guess that his girlfriend or wife was probably Cruella. Who knows? But anyway, he was really excited about it. And that's what it's going to be sometimes. You know, you think like, are you kidding me? Like, that's what you want? And they get super pumped up, you know? You'd be surprised when it comes to face painting, how sometimes the little things can be huge to some person. I mentioned it last time that I ended up putting a fireball, a whiskey bottle on somebody, and they loved it, and it was super cool, and I was happy to do it. So like I said, you just never know. So today, in terms of the stories, I admitted that I'm just going to talk about, I'll give you at least, you know, kind of the idea that I'm going for is our super helper, okay? A super helper, so just keep that in mind. The super helper, which can be a good thing, could also be a bad thing. Just depends on where you draw the line, right? So anyway, before we do that, I definitely want to invite you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. Check out the new graphic right down here. You can see, I'll probably keep the other, YouTube subscribe button as well, but I just wanted to make sure you could see this little baby down here. Okay, I think you saw that. Good. Alrighty, another thing I want to make sure to remind you of is if you haven't gone to my merch shop, you can definitely do that. Get yourself a nice t-shirt. I just added a face painter one over there as well. It should be live on the site too. You can check it out. It comes in. I try to keep like bright colors for face painters, but also I probably should add a dark, because I know that if you're face painting, you know, you may not be able to keep your clothes as clean as you want them to be. And then anyway, I think we got that stuff out of the way. I have more balloon tutorials on the way as well. And then product reviews. And so I think we should just go into the super helper, and I'll tell you about what happened to me in this case. I was at an event where I got to sit down, and our super helper, of course, is our kiddo that wants to do what we do. And and you know what? You don't want to discourage them, you know, especially if they look up to you in that moment in time. And you know, even the adults will support this as well. They'll be like, oh, look at that. You got a little helper, you know, a little protege, you know. And I would joke like, yeah, if they get too good, they're going to put me out of a job, you know. So anyway, in this case, little helper, super helper was, you know, reaching into my balloons. And, you know, at first, you know, we try to be polite about it, and we're, you know, I was like, hey, you know, why don't you tell me what color you want, and I'll get it out of there for you, you know? Because now we're just thinking about, in my brain, I'm thinking like, okay, what are some good excuses to come up with? So they start reaching into the kit, you know, without being mean, and, you know, worst case scenario, being like, get your hands out of there, right? So that's the first thing I'm doing to try to curb that a little bit, is I'm saying, hey, why don't you tell me what color you want, you know, and we'll pull it out of there and you can give it a shot, you know. And right away, I'm laying down this gauntlet. I'm like, hey, dude, you know, if you try to inflate that by mouth, it's going to be really tough. I would discourage it. So right away, it comes right back at it with, oh, I could use the pump, you know, and I have a floor pump. So a floor pump is, you know, if you're vertically challenged, and I am to a degree, you know, especially for the kid though, you know, it's going to be difficult to get that pump up there to actually use it, you know, and get some success with it. So anyway, so right away, now we got to deal with that. Well, you know, the pump, you know, it's an expensive thing. So again, like I said, I'm just trying to lay down all these obstacles. And you probably think to yourself when you're reading this, God, dog, you really are bending over backwards in this scenario. But I just want you to keep in mind, you know, that I... it depends on where you draw the line and where your boundaries are, you know? So anyway, we go through all that and you know, there's a little bit of balloon twisting here and there. Oh, teach me how to do this, teach me how to do that. Meanwhile, I am hired to be here and do some work. I have to, you know, try to balance the two. Like, well, okay, give me a second. I'll show you this in just a moment, okay? But first I got to make sure to take care of these 20 people before I can help, you know, or give you a private lesson on balloon animals. So anyway, so you know, we get to that part, and then I'm also going to be doing airbrush paint. Oh well, you know, I can help you do airbrush paint. So I'm thinking, yeah, I guess you could, you could give it a shot, huh? I mean, I'm just using stencils, right? And so anyway, that lasted about 5 seconds before I realized, like, oh, that this is not gonna work out one bit. And so definitely I had to draw a hard line there and be like, hey, why don't you go help your mom or dad serve some food, right? And so little super helper leaves to go do that, but I swear, only like 5 seconds, they're back at the table, you know, trying to rummage through the balloons, and while I'm talking to someone and twisting and having a good time, and I look down and little hands are in there, and I'm like, ah, you know, and right away, like, hey, like back up to the side or back to that side of the table. And so that works out. But then I end up making a unicorn, right? And little helper can't help himself, and right away looks at the unicorn and says, oh, look at that unicorn, it's so h-o-r-n-y.
Do I make you Randy?
Yeah, I had to spell it for you just because I don't want YouTube kicking me off of the platform and making sure that I can't bring a video for you. And I was like, ch-ch-ch. I said, you can't say that. Like, for, you know, I said, these are our guests. He goes, what? I can't say. And then he says it again. I was like, yeah. I said, and then I tried to bring it up again. Like, hey, did you finish helping your mom or dad, like, serve food and make sure that the guests have drinks? I said, you are part of the host here. You must help them. You know, and so finally super helper bounced out, but that was a tough one, you know, overcoming, like, trying to give the polite balloon lessons on the side and trying to, you know, really help them, and then also when it came to the airbrush, I couldn't mess around when it came to the airbrush, because, you know, if you do, you gotta wipe it off and start all over again. It becomes a whole fiasco when it comes to that kind of stuff. So anyway, I'll draw that to an end and just kind of let you know that, hey, not every single time, every event is going to be, like, you know, just smooth sailing, easy to go. You're definitely gonna run into some obstacles here and there, but you know, hopefully you're hearing that, you realize, like, dude, I thought everything was always going great. No, it's not going great every time. So you have to be a professional, remain calm, draw those lines and those boundaries. But I'd love to hear from you. What is some event that you went through recently where you're like, oh man, this is a tough one. I really had to earn my money on this one, right? And really, set some boundaries and really control my group and manage them well. That's what I'm going for, controlling and managing them. You know, for us as entertainers, not only is it up to us to entertain them, but also manage them in a sense, you know, like I've talked about this before, but to end here, I think it's the last thing, is keeping your group, like, in a line. Sometimes that helps versus, you know, a mob, because a mob can take over really fast and be like, I was here first, you know, now you're the bad guy, because now you gotta, you know, pass some kind of judgment and create some order out of this chaos of people, like, looking at you to entertain them, you know? So anyway, I'll go ahead and, again, like I said, I was cutting out from story time, but also, again, want to remind you to visit my merch shop. That way you can get over there and get yourself a nice shirt. Maybe you can say here, like, also, you know, get a shirt that says, maybe I'll make one, line manager, you know, or event manager. Well, actually, no, I take that back. That old event opened up a whole new can of worms that maybe you don't want, so... So I'm going to go ahead and peace out, and I'll see you guys next time with another balloon tutorial. Alrighty, happy twisting, everybody. Bye.